We run along, and we come up with this idea to go down to the stream and check it out for fish. So we went to the river downstream, and there's half a foot of water there and a silver fish, but nothing substantial, until one of our boys calls us further down. Lying in the water is a wee foal, 4 or 5 days old. He was all skin and bone, a gray color, and he's got flakes of blood in his coat, because he's cut himself up really badly in the sharp rocks. We were standing over him, and you could see his back leg snapped. He's breathing, he's alive, but just about. So this big conversation gets started up between the boys, who suddenly reckon themselves the leaders, and the liberating is what we should do. Someone says drop a rock on his head, but I'm looking in their faces, and I can see they are either scared, stiff, or clueless. It's all bravado. And this foal on the ground in real pain. This chit chat going on, going nowhere. Next thing, one of our priests sees us, sees the foal, tells us not to move it, that we were done for. We were really done for. Group of boys will always get the blame for hurting the foal. Belfast boys will get a hammering for sure. So it's clear to me in an instant. I get down on my knees and take the foal's head in my hands, and I put him underwater. He's thrashing around a bit at the start. So I press down harder until he's down. Grabbing me by the hair, dragging me through the woods, promising me a proper punishment. But I knew I did the right thing by the wee foal, and I could take the punishment for all our boys. I had the respect of the other boys now, and I knew that. I'm clear of the reasons, Don, and clear of all the repercussions. But I will act, and I will not stand by and do nothing.